My dear students, assalamu alaikum and very good morning to all of you. This is your science teacher, Mohammad Firoz Mahmud, Milestone School and College, Sector 4 Branch. Today, I will discuss with you Chapter 3, Class 8, Lesson 1 to 5. So, dear students, let's go to our today's class. Today, I will discuss at first diffusion. Matters are made up of small molecules. These molecules are always in motion. In case of liquid and gas, the motion of these molecules are very fast and show tendency to diffuse towards the regions with lower concentration from higher ions. This movement of molecules continues as long as the concentration of the two regions becomes equal. I mean, for liquid and gas, their motion is very fast, and this movement of molecules continues as long as the concentration of the two regions become equal. There is an example for you. If you will open a cork of perfume in the corner of your room, you will find that it sprayed the whole room. How is it possible? It is possible due to diffusion. Now we can say that what is the definition of diffusion? The process through which the molecules of any substance are spread from the region of its higher concentration to the region of lower concentration is called diffusion. I mean, the process through which the molecules of any substance are spread from region of its higher concentration to the region of lower concentration is called diffusion. I mean, the spread of gas or liquid from one place to another place from higher concentration to lower concentration. Now, my dear students, what are the importance of diffusion? Diffusion takes place in every physiological process of organism. During photosynthesis, plants absorb carbon dioxide and release oxygen as byproducts. Diffusion makes this essential task possible. Living cells use oxygen for the oxidation of glucose. Oxygen enters into the cells through diffusion, and the release carbon dioxide also occurs in the same way. I mean, they are the importance of diffusion. Now, dear students, the loss of water in the form of water vapors through transpiration is the result of diffusion. I mean, the loss of water, we know that plants absorb water, and they also loss of water in the form of water vapors through transpiration is the result of diffusion. I mean, they absorb water, and the unnecessary water they can release by this process. In case of animal respiration, exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide, carrying of food, oxygen, etc., from blood to lymph and from lymph to blood cells occur through diffusion. I mean, in case of animal respiration, exchange of oxygen exchange and carbon dioxide, carrying of food, oxygen, etc., from blood to lymph and from lymph to cells occur through diffusion. I mean, it will be occurs by the diffusion. Now, osmosis. To understand the process of osmosis, we need to know the characteristics of the membrane separating two differently concentrated solution. Membrane are three types. My dear students, membrane are three types. Number one, impermeable membrane. Number two, permeable membrane. And number three, semipermeable membrane. Picture of osmosis. Look at here. There are two solutions. One is water and another is sugar. And there is a semipermeable membrane. My dear students, look at here, impermeable membrane. The membrane through which molecule of both solute and solvent cannot pass. We know that if you want to make a solution, you need solute and solvent. So impermeable membrane is one kind of membrane through which molecule of both solute and solvent cannot pass. Example, polythene. Can water or can any solute pass through polythene? No. Solute and solvent cannot pass through it. So this is the example of impermeable membrane. Impermeable means solute and solvent both cannot pass. Another example is cell wall made of cutin. Now, dear students, impermeable membrane. Impermeable membrane. The membrane through which molecules of both solute and solvent can pass easily. Solute and solvent both can pass is known as permeable membrane. For example, cell wall. Now, semipermeable membrane. The membrane through which only the solvent molecules like as water in case of plants can pass but not the solute molecules is called semipermeable membrane. Semipermeable membrane is one kind of membrane through which only the solvent molecule can pass but not solute. Only solvent can pass. Example, cell membrane, membrane inside the eggshell, membrane of fish potka, swim bladder or air bladder, etc. So osmosis, the process where the solvent from dilute solution diffuse through a semipermeable membrane into the highly concentrated solution is called osmosis. The process where the solvent from dilute solution diffuse through a semipermeable membrane into the highly concentrated solution is called the osmosis. For osmosis only solvent can pass. If you make a solution by sugar and water, then only water can pass but not salt. Now, cell membrane or plasma membrane of the living organism acts as semipermeable membrane. Mineral salts dissolve in water, enter into and pass out from the cell through plasma membrane. Intracellular water and the mineral salt solution together is called cell sap or simply sap. So osmosis plays a very important role in maintaining different physiochemical process of the cell. By this process, plants absorb water and mineral dissolve in water from soil through unicellular root hair. By this process, plants absorb water and minerals dissolve in water from soil through unicellular root hair. Due to osmosis, turgidity of the cell is increased. That keeps stem and leaf fresh and straight. Also, plants can open and close its petals. In the intestine of the animals, digested food may be absorbed. I mean, by this process, digested food also absorbed. Absorption of water and mineral salts. Mechanism of water absorption in plants. My dear students, we know that water is very much essential for plants for preparing their food by the photosynthesis process and also mineral salt. So how can they absorb the plant water and mineral salt? These two processes are not same. Absorption of water and mineral salts are not same. So mechanism of water absorption in plants. At first, I am going to discuss with you that how can plants absorb the water. The process by which living cells of plant body intake water and mineral salt dissolved in water is generally known as absorption. I mean, the process by which living cells of plant body intake water and mineral salt dissolved in water is generally known as absorption. That is known as absorption. Now, terrestrial land plants absorb water from soil through root hair. Submerged plant. Submerged means the plants which live in water. They are known as the submerged plant. So, submerged plants absorb water through their whole body. The root hairs of the terrestrial plants. My dear students, for your better understanding, there is a video. So everybody,
how do plants absorb water?
How do
plants now? Let us understand water. How plants absorb water. The roots absorb most of the water that goes into plants. That is why we give water to the soil and not on the leaves. The responsibility of absorption of water and minerals is more specifically the function of the root hairs that are present in millions at the tips of the roots. Root hairs are thin-walled, slender extensions of root epidermal cells that greatly increase the surface area for absorption. Water is absorbed along with mineral solutes by the root hairs purely by diffusion. Once water is absorbed by the root hairs, it can move deeper into root layers by two distinct pathways.
So, dear students, I think you have observed this video and you will get more idea that how can plants absorb water. Intake capillary water of the soil particles through osmosis. The wall of the root hairs is permeable. I mean, the wall of the root hair is permeable. So first, it absorbs water through imbibitions, and the absorbed water comes in contact with semi-permeable plasma membrane below the cell wall. The concentration of the central solution of root hair is higher than that of its environment, and thus water solvent enters into the cell through endosmosis. The concentration of the cell cell from the outer membrane to the center of the root cells is not equal. Consequently, due to intercellular osmosis, water flows from one cell to another and finally reaches the leaves through xylem bases of the stem. Now, inhibition. The process by which colloidal substance cell in plants absorb different liquid, water in case of plant is called imbibition. I mean, the process by which colloidal substances, cell in plants, absorb different liquid is called imbibition. Now, my dear students, there is another video that how can plant absorb mineral salt?
Absorption of mineral salts. The absorption of salt is independent of the absorption of water. That is, water and minerals are not absorbed together. They are absorbed separately. Salts are not absorbed as molecules but as ions. Potassium nitrate, KNO3, does not enter the root as such but as K positive potassium ions and NO3 negative nitrate. Salt, Na positive, Cl negative, enters into the root by diffusion. The ions move from a region of higher concentration towards the region of lower concentration. They move according to concentration gradient. Salts are absorbed in the form of ions. Example, potassium nitrate is absorbed in the form of K positive and NO3 negative. Here, movement of ions takes place from higher concentration to lower concentration. If absorption takes place according to concentration gradient, it is called passive absorption. But if concentration of a particular mineral is higher inside the cell sap and further same ion is needed, then the absorption takes place against the concentration gradient. This type of absorption needs energy and is called active absorption. The upward movement of water and minerals from the roots towards the top of the plant is known as ascent of sap. Factors affecting ascent of sap. Root pressure. Root pressure is the force developed in the xylem of the root that can push the sap into certain height.
So, dear students, from this video, we have learned that plants cannot take the mineral salt. They can take the mineral salt like as ion, I mean cation and anion, positive and negative. Now, absorption of mineral salt by plants. Description: plant absorb a good deal of mineral salt from the soil for their development and physiological need. Mineral salt remains in solution form in the soil. The mineral salt remains a solute with capillary water of soil, but the absorption process of water and mineral salt are different and there is no relation between the two processes. Plant cannot absorb the whole salt molecule. They absorb salt only in the form of ion. Already I have told it to you that they will just take the salt like as ion. However, the salt absorption process is divided into two parts, inactive absorption and active absorption. So, my dear students, from our today's video class, what did we learn? We have learned at first diffusion. We know that the process by which liquid and gas spread from higher concentration to lower concentration is known as diffusion. And we have learned about osmosis, inhibition and their importance. And we have learned that how can plant absorb water and mineral salt. So my dear students, there are some important things from our today's class that we have also learned, that what is membrane, what is permeable membrane, what is semi-permeable membrane, and what is impermeable membrane. And we know that plant water and mineral salt is very much important for the plant, but they will not, or the process of taking the plant, taking the water and mineral salt are not same. They will take mineral salt like as ion, I mean positive or negative cation or anion. Now my dear students, there are some related questions for you. At first, this is comprehension based question. This is comprehension based question. At first, dry wood is hydrophilic. Explain it. You have to explain that dry wood is hydrophilic. Number two, why called semi-permeable membrane of the fish feeble? Number three, why water and mineral salts are important for the growth of tree? We know that for the people, I mean for us, nutrients are very much essential for development of our body. So for the plant's body, water and mineral salts also very much important, because without water they cannot produce their food by the photosynthesis process. So you have to explain it, that why water and mineral salts are important for the growth of tree. Now why polythene is an impermeable membrane? Dear student, you know that impermeable means the membrane through which solute and solvent both cannot pass. So polythene, through polythene can pass water and any solute? No. So it is impermeable membrane. You have to explain it. Now question number 5. Write to difference between diffusion and osmosis. You have to explain diffusion and osmosis. My dear students, you know that for comprehension based question, at first you have to make it two para. At first you have to write the first para, then you have to explain. If there is example, you must have give the example. Now homework. My dear students, related question number 1 to 5 is your Learn Plus writing homework. My dear students, thank you very much for joining of today's video class. Although this session is very bad, but you have to study in your house, stay home, stay safe. Allah Hafiz.